my little friend, Uncle Louie, Common Kings. We're with Fresh TV.
What up, y'all? It's your boys, Common Kings. Welcome to Fresh.
Here's what we got for you freshies coming up today.
Who is the worst member of Common Kings to tour with, and Mata. Why?
I'm sorry.
Tell me how you really feel.
Diddly dee potatoes. You know, I feel like some bangers of mash now, innit?
On that day, Master Wayne, I won't want to be right.
Who's the freshest member of Common Kings? Do you wanna go? No, not by a mile. It's this guy. Junior King, Swagalicious, yes. AKA
Winning
Trendsetter.
Smell good.
His breath smells pretty fresh too.
Oh wait.
Tonight's aim was to launch the ethnic, indigenous, and Pacific models to the commercial world. My name is Terri Smith, and I am the owner and creative director of Terri Creative Services and Management.
Keep it fresh with Terri Creative.
Sometimes I tend to lose myself.
We are at my official industry launch. We had about 27 of our models here tonight.
I believe there is so much talent. We have so many beautiful faces, so many people with talent. So my aim is to create the platform in order to launch our people to the commercial world.
Keeping it fresh.
I've been casting now for nearly 3 months. The models send through their photos online, and then basically from there, I select who I'd like to interview face to face. I now have an agency down in Marrickville, Sydney. All my models come and meet there. Literally, the model comes in, we do a photo shoot. I interview them and see where they want to go with their modeling aspirations, and then we take it from there.
Hey guys, my name is Peter, I'm Samoan German, and I'm one of the models for Terri Creatives. I just had a knack for it, so decided to do it.
Got models from Fiji, Queensland, New Zealand, Australian Aboriginals. We had ethnic models coming from Nigeria, from Africa.
I like her vision. She wants to bring more opportunities for the Pacific, ethnic, and indigenous models out there, so.
Pay attention to people like this because they're the real role models in our community. Terri Smith, remember that name, Pez.
Freshest things about tonight has to be the donuts.
Yes! Definitely the donuts, guys.
I went straight to the food. I only came here for the food, so yeah. Model facials. Oh, the trick is you kind of like suck it in, like that, and then you just go.
I'm excited to create opportunities for the models in a commercial environment. I'm looking forward to helping them push and spread their wings and fly as far as they can go. So guys, oh, Sombo. Keeping it fresh with that. Keeping it fresh here with Tez.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, coming to you hard, harder than ever, we have upcoming stories about people that don't know what they're doing when they're in front of the camera, like myself. This next segment is about knowing your roots. What do you know about your roots? And we're not talking about your hair roots. We're talking about your family roots, your heritage roots. Cut.
Know your roots. Because next time you have a debate with someone, make sure your fax machine is plugged in. Egg, stupid. Deep in the Pacific jungle live the islands of the Pacific called the Pacific Islands. But one country you might have heard of is Samoa. If you haven't heard of Samoa, I'm sure you've dreamed about it. You know, The Rock, Khan Fotuali, and SBW. Yes, the guy in the picture, not the car. Yes, in Samoa, you have the spunky guys and, of course, the smelly-licious women. Bunny and Bunny. I didn't say that. Yes, I did. And on top of the icing cake, the third gender of Samoa and the queens of the scene. No, not Queen Salote. We are talking about the Fafafines. That's right, girl! Now, we've all wondered why sometimes Auntie sings bass in the church choir. Have we? Anyway, here's a little bit of insight of who, what, when, where, why, how far, and wherefore art thou Fafafine facts. The defining of the word Fafafine simply means like a woman and is used to describe a boy who's too cool for rugby shorts and EFI gangas. Yeah, take the metaphor before I foil your ulu with it. What? One popular idea about why there's so many Fafafine is that back in the day, there were too many boys. So then one of them takes on the girls' jobs because he was a bit lazy. And who else is gonna help mum clean the house, huh? The Fafafines of the village were known to be the ones to stay home and take care of the folks once they was get too old, while all the other siblings was go around, muck around the downtown and extending the family nation of the generation. What? When Christians came in the wakas in the 19th century, many things got turned topsy-topsy-topsy upside down. Clothes was the new fashion, and the third gender was not appreciated for their many skills in life. These days, Fafafine has become a personal choice and not so much a boy picked to do the girls' chores around the house. That's lucky. Know your roots and know people before you judge people, because if you don't know your roots will be pulled off your ulu by my bare hands and used as Fafa's hair extensions for Saturday night and matafanga. Better than a horse hair, eh?
Stay right where you are, fam.
We got the freshest of the fresh right after the break.
Keep it fresh.
Walks up to her and he goes,
what do you do?
What do you do?
Crying.
And she goes, I'm not pregnant.
Oh, my God.
Fresh.
Aye.
Fry.
Oh, you gave me a big fry.
Nothing to be afraid of.
Okay, what's up?
Welcome back to Fresh.
It's your boys,
Comic Kings.
This is what's going on in our world today. I think that's the wrong line.
Who is the worst member of Common Kings to tour with? And why?
Tell me how you really feel.
I came out way too fast and quick and easy.
Yeah, so and true.
What is Mata?
Hello and welcome to our interview here. This is Jerome interviewing these fine young men here. Where are you guys based?
Orange County, California.
Do you have a big Pacific community?
Yeah, we do.
We actually do, yeah. It's actually a good mix, right? Samoans and Tongans. Samoans, Tongans, there's a lot of Hawaiians as well.
Yeah. There's a lot of Chamorros too.
It's pretty diverse out there.
What is the ethnic makeup of the Common Kings?
Oh.
What kind of makeup do you like?
I'm Samoan. I'm Samoan.
I'm Samoan Hawaiian.
I'm Fijian.
Hold up, give us your Fijian accent. Come on, bro.
Ah, come on, brother.
Hey, Isale.
Next question.
Out of all of us, who has the freshest family?
Oh.
All our families are fresh, man.
Families are fresh, bro.
Some fresh families.
Yes, super fresh.
What have you been up to since the last time we were here on Fresh? Lost in
Paradise. Dropped an album?
Yes, we just released the album.
Lost in Paradise.
Did you hear it yet?
Yes, I've heard it many times.
The drummer's pretty good. Drummer's pretty good.
I mean, it's a good album. It's
very good. Yeah?
It's a good album?
It's a very good album.
That's all you got great questions, man. Yes.
I'm the interview person here, so.
You're awesome.
The best.
Johnny Carson's got nothing on it. Thank you.
You you're really known for your reggae style, but you started out as a cover band. What were the songs that you loved to cover?
Ooh. Good question, man. We used to do a lot of AC/DC, some Guns N' Roses. Maybe not AC/DC, but Guns N' Roses. Okay, we did some Stevie Wonder.
Stevie Wonder.
Some Michael Jackson.
That was fun to play.
Journey.
Yep. I think Journey was probably my favorite to play because everybody in the club, no matter whether they were black, white, Hispanic, Chinese, they all were white that day.
Yeah, they were.
So was we. Don't stop
believing. You guys know any New Zealand artists? And who are your favorites at the moment?
Rod. Gosh. You gotta be Rod.
Rod, know ya. This is forever, this
forever love.
Sammy J.
Three Houses Down.
Catch a Fire. That was our very first tour, was with the boys from Catch a Fire.
Yeah. The list goes on and on.
What is the most embarrassing thing that has ever happened on tour?
Mata. So we're in Maui, right? We're backstage. Very sweet lady. Walks up to her and he goes, oh my gosh, what are you doing? When are you due? She started almost crying. She goes,
I'm not pregnant.
Oh my God.
And she's never come to a show after that. Yeah. Love you, Barbara. I'm so sorry.
Well, thank you for joining my interview here. We are Common Kings, and this is my world.
That's our world.
What kind of food do you like?
I think he heard one of our answers.
That's your press figure?
Yes. Next question.
All right, fellas, what's your favorite food to eat on the road? The question is, what isn't the food that we don't eat on the road?
We do not discriminate. That is for sure.
Definitely.
We love all foods.
When in Rome, we eat Romans. All right, Roman foods.
Roman.
And when in New Zealand, we eat sheep.
Kia ora na, my name is Lanita and welcome to my whare. Today I'm going to be all about different tastes and different flavours from a classic cookie sense for a Polly Dolly platter. Today's Polly Dolly platter, I've got three features. They're inspired by my mum's whānau in the Cook Islands. We're going to go ikamata, minus, and a crumbed mussel. Let's get into it. So we start with the fish. There's variations all over the Pacific, in Samoa, it's oka, in Tahiti, it's got a French twist, but I'm gonna do the one that mum does for us in our whānau, and it's very, very simple. My mum's one, we like to do tomatoes, onion, cucumber, and then we top it off with a bit of spring onion. The key ingredient is actually the coconut cream. Today we're gonna do a bit of a cheat. You've got to do the kantanga and that's okay. Don't do the Thai ones, it just makes it taste completely different. And then literally just add the rest of your ingredients. Let it sit in the fridge for a while and it'll solidify a little bit and be better. Minus is a dish that's quite famous in the Cook Islands. Here's the classic version from our family. Now the thing about minus, which cracks me up, is the name. I haven't been told the story officially, but I totally believe that it's called minus because it's the fresh way of saying mayonnaise. And I think someone was trying to say mayonnaise, but they just said minus. City styles don't have term. We're gonna go best foods. So you can do your beetroot from scratch, but I'm gonna do the other quick way from the can. I actually don't know how it became into the salad, but there is a Know Your Roots story where it accidentally fell in and then became a craze. I think it's because us cookies like a lot of colour and we wanted to have a potato salad that was even more fabulous than anywhere else. So we made it pink. The other secret ingredient that not everyone puts in, but my family put in, is the chow chow. I think it helps cut through the cream. And then the other thing that we like to put in is the good old mixed veggies. So this is actually quite a healthy like version of a potato salad, if you think about all the veggies that are in it. Ingredients for this one is really, really easy. We'll start with a hefty teaspoon of trusty garlic. Same with the ginger, a little bit of onion in that. The biggest thing really is the breadcrumbs. You know when you go to the islands, you get those fabulous platters where all the mussels are fried. this is a nice way of having mussels, not with all the batter, but still like tasting good. Okay, ta-da! We have your Poly Dolly platter. It is a trio of tropical tastes with the ikamata, the crumb mussels, and the minus. Kia ora, mai take mata.
Don't go anywhere, freshies.
We got that freshness coming right up.
Keep it fresh!
So basically, I've come up with an answer.
Yeah.
Well, I haven't. But Mariah at home does.
Yeah.
But you're a liar.
Sorry?
You're a liar.
Chick.
Yeah.
Chicken. Oh, man. Do you watch the new Fresh TV? Ooh, that's that girl.
Yeah.
She is beautiful, man.
She is smart.
She is kind.
Yeah.
She can do anything, man.
She can be my girlfriend.
No, she can't.
So what's your business, Imanex? How's it going?
Oh, now, bro. You get the acorn. Yeah, man. Welcome back to Fresh.
Welcome.
Hands up. Okay, who here believes in psychics?
What? Oh, no.
No, not.
No. Not me. Have any of you been to one? And did any of the things that they say come true? If you're planning on going to one, definitely don't go to these guys.
Kulukus, they are everywhere, living among us. Who are they? Why are they?
I can't find my iPhone.
Your neighbors, friends, family.
So they tell me, we didn't get the money. So I just want to know if you can tell me, where does the money go?
We have a lot of work to do in this realm.
There are mediums everywhere, but only two lodges.
We can't truly know who the real Kulukus are. That's why we need the help of the gifted.
Your name, please, sir.
My name is,
Sorry?
Sir?
I don't know. I have no idea what you just said.
My name is Bradley.
And what is it that you're after, Bradley?
I say about a couple months ago, I took some
let's
money.
Just get to the gist. So, yeah. Let's
yeah. Just... Oh, basically, I'm sending money to my family.
Oh, you got money? How much money did you send them?
Oh, it's about $108. So they told me, I said, oh, we didn't get the money. So I just want to know if you can tell me.
Okay.
Where does the money go?
And where does the money go? In order for me to find where the money went, I need Bradley to walk us through the last moments he saw the money.
Behind the shop. Say, just like next to the... There's like a car next to there, and there's just like a rubbish next to the car. It's really itchy over here. So what happened was I took it, I walked down to this aisle, it's what do you call, like a dark alleyway?
Yes.
Yeah, and then this man say, oh, you're sending money to over there? I said, yeah, I'm sending money to over there. And then I give him the money. He give me a receipt.
I'm taking everything in, and I really hope that everything comes back out.
The next exercise involves...
Automatic writing is a special skill that involves good writing, automatically. I'm talking to you facing you.
Yeah.
And an entity will enter my right hand when you start talking.
Okay.
If it doesn't fall asleep. And it's going to show where the funds went to.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. $108
yes.
And 52 cents.
Yes.
With the fee, it's about an extra $200.
Yes.
So it's about $300 all up.
Okay, excellent. So basically, I've come up with an answer.
Yeah.
Well, I haven't, but Mariah at home has.
Yeah.
But you're a liar.
Sorry?
You're a liar because the spirit told me.
I'm silly.
That you went to McDonald's and you bought three Big Macs, six fillets.
Oh.
Two chicken nuggets.
No, I think it was chicken meal.
10 times
yeah.
In the span of 3 minutes. And I think you actually need help with your articulation because I had no idea what you just said. I don't know where you're from. Where are you from?
From Saipan.
So what we've got to do, right, is we've got to change your accent. Because I'm also a clairvoyant.
Okay.
And a clairaudient and clairsentient. So what I'm going to do, right, is I'm going to hypnotise you.
Yeah.
Although it's got nothing to do with being clairvoyant. And we're going to change your accent.
Thank you.
Okay.
Okay.
So look into my eyes. My eyes over here.
Okay.
And go into a complete trance. 3, 2, 1. 1, 2, 3. Take a deep breath. Breathe out. Oh, shocker. Just breathe back in again and breathe out that way. Excellent. Okay, now let's see what you've got to say. How do you feel?
I don't quite know how to feel about this. To be very honest, what's happened to my voice?
Oh my gosh, I don't know what's going on here.
I can understand everything you're saying now. Isn't that amazing?
Diddly dee potatoes. You know, I feel like some bangers and mash now, innit?
On that day, Master Wayne, I won't want to be right. Listen, and you don't do the broken voice unless it's very, very emotional. She was only 16.
And today, Matthew, I'm going to be doing my mate, Harry Potter. Oh, Quidditch. Yeah, you better Quidditch.
Isn't that amazing? Just like that. If you believe in trancing.
I don't know how to repay you.
You actually have an
extra. I don't know how to pay you. I don't have any money because I'm looking for it, innit?
That's us, we're out, freshies.
It's been super dope chilling with y'all today.
And here's what's coming up next week.
I'm Tomini, and welcome to Fresh.
This week you're here with me on the Rock of Polynesia, New Air, and I can't wait to show you fellas around.
Until next week, freshies.
Keep it fresh!
Supporting local content so you can see more of New Zealand on air.